Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to talk about introduction to binary search. This is one of the searching techniques. Previously I have already explained the linear search and the program required, C program required for a linear search. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link over here. In this session, I am going to focus on binary search. So let's start with a binary search. Binary search is one of the searching techniques. Always you need to keep in mind that this searching technique always works for a sorted list. It doesn't matter your list is in ascending order or in descending order. Accordingly, you need to do some changes in your algorithm, but it will work for a sorted list only. How it works? So basically, if it is a searching algorithm, it is used to search a particular key value from a sorted list. I repeat, we are going to perform searching on a sorted list only with the help of binary search. So this will be performed by performing successively eliminating half of the array. Means we'll divide our list and we'll conquer our requirement, that is searching of a particular element. So this algorithm, binary search algorithm, is successively eliminates the half of the list, means it divides the list and it conquers the result. Whatever, if the searching is successful or not successful, is going to be conquered by dividing a list successively. It is implemented either with the help of loop or it can be implemented recursively. So the algorithm I'll explain in my next video, but in this session I would like to explain you the binary search with the help of example. So now how the binary search works. So now let's see, we are having an array of 15 numbers. In these 15 numbers, I need to declare the variable low as well as variable high. Variable low I need to declare at the position 0, high I need to declare at the position n-1. Initially my low is at the position 0, my high is at n-1, that is 14 position, as the 15 values are here. Now my searching key is 33. I want to search 33 in my list. Now what I need to do? So the first thing is to find out a mid of my list, because I need to divide my list. I need to check whether at the mid of the list my key element is present or not. So how I will find out the mid? For that I'll perform the addition of low plus high, that is divided by 2, is nothing but the mid of the list. So 0 plus 14 divided by 2 is 7, so 7 is my mid of the list. Now what I'll do, the next step will be, I'll compare the element which is present at the mid of the list with the key element. Are they equal or not? That is array of mid element of my array is equal to key element or not? So what you will say, my key element is 33, is it equal to 53? No, it's not equal. It means that I need to divide my list, and in this case I need to move to the left sub list, because my key element is less than the mid of the array. So in this way I am not going to consider these rest of the elements of my array. I will focus on this divided list, that is left sub list, to search my key element from the list. How I am going to decide that? That I will decide as per the condition, like if my key element is less than the array of mid, I will use the left sub list. Otherwise, if my key element is greater than the array of mid, then I will use the right sub list. But in our case, the mid was 53 and my key is 33. 33, as the list is sorted, means it will be presenting in the left sub list. So that's why I will update my high to divide my list. So my new high, what it will be? I'll keep my low to zero as it is, but I'll update my high. High will be mid. What was the previous mid? That was 7 minus 1, because now I'm going to divide a least. So that's why 7 minus 1 is 6. So now I'll consider this half of the least only. Now here I am reducing the time required for a searching, because these elements I am not going to compare. These elements I am going to totally ignore from my list, as I am knowing that 33 is less than 53, means I need to focus on the half of the list only. Here what I need to do next thing is to find out the mid of my current list. So my low is 0, high is 6, mid is low plus high, that is 0 plus 6 divided by 2 is 3. So my mid is at the position 3 in my array. Next thing, after getting the mid position, I need to check whether the mid of array is equal to my key or not. So let's check. Mid of array is 25, is equal to my key is 33. Are they equal? No. So what I need to do? I need to take a decision. Where to move? Where or which sublist I need to take, consider, or we need to focus on which sublist, that is either left sublist or the right sublist. From which I'll decide? I'll decide from this condition, that is, if my key is greater than array of mid, I need to move to the right subtree, sublist, and if my key is less than the mid, then I need to move to the left sublist. So here key is greater than array of mid, I need to move to the right sub list. So what I'll do now, as I want to move to the right sub list, I need to update the low position. High will be as it is, but now what will be my new low? New low will be mid plus 1. It means that if I want to move to the right sub list, I need to update the low by adding 1 to the previous mid. But if I need to move to the left sublist, I need to update the high by subtracting 1 from a mid. So here I am going to ignore this half of the list and I'll focus on this list only, where my new low is 4 and my high will be as it is, because I had moved to the right sublist. So now what I need to do? What I need to do next? That is, I need to find out a mid again. So what I'll do, 4 plus 6, that is my low is 4, high is 6, and addition of that is divided by 2 is nothing but my new mid. So it is nothing but 5. What I'll do, I'll assign this mid to the position 5. The next condition is to check whether the mid of array is equal to key, that is 43 is equal to my key, that is 33. Are they equal? No. So what I need to do, I need to check next more condition, whether my key is less than array of mid or greater than array of mid. If it is less, what I need to move, or what I need to do, I need to move to the left sublist. So for moving to the left sublist, what I need to do, I need to update my high. So what that high will be? So this high is nothing but the previous mid minus 1. Previous mid was 5, minus 1 is nothing but 4. So here my new high will be at the position 4. Low was at the position 4 itself. My new high is also at the same position. Now let's calculate a mid. Mid is nothing but low plus high divided by 2. 4 plus 4 is 8 divided by 2 is nothing but 4. So what I need to do the next thing? I need to check whether my array of mid is equal to key element or not. Yes, both are equal. And what it indicates that my search is successful and the key 33 is found at location 4. So in this way the binary search is working if the key element is present in my array, that is, search is successful. Now let's see one more example with which I'll explain that the search is unsuccessful. Again, here the another example I am going to use. Again, the list is a sorted form, that is in ascending order. Total 17 numbers are there with me, which will be helpful to give the index position. Now let's start with the minimum maximum. Here you can use the low or high, the pair of low or high, or you can use the variable name mean or max to indicate the lower boundary of the array and the upper boundary of array, or lower boundary of your least and the upper boundary of your least. So now initially mean is initialized to 0, max is initialized to n minus 1. Now let's check. So what the number you want to search is 43. Compare it with your mid 33. Are they equal? No. So what I need to do the next thing, let's check whether the mid is less than 43 or greater than 43. So mid is less than 43 means somewhere the key element which I want to search is present in the right sub least of the mid. So what I'll do, I'll divide the least by performing the addition by 2, by adding 1 to the mid, that will be my new mean. So now my new mean will be 9, where previously mid was 8, and 8 plus 1 is my new mean. Now my new mid is nothing but 9 plus 16 is 25 divided by 2 is 12. So my new mid is 12. Let's check whether my 58, that is array of mid, is less than 43 or greater than 43. 58 is greater than 43, that is key value. It indicates that somewhere the 43 can be present in a left sub list, where min will be as it is, but my max is going to be update is nothing but the previous mid minus 1. So 12 minus 1 is nothing but 11 will be my new max. So now let's see, max is nothing but 11, mid is nothing but 9. 9 plus 11 is 20 divided by 2 is 10. So my mid is at position 10. Now let's check whether my 43 is equal to 41 or not. They are not. So now let's check whether 43 is less than 41 or greater than 41. 43 is greater than 41. It indicates that somewhere in the right sub list, 43 may be present in the list. For this, I need to update my mean as I want to move to the right sub list. While moving to the right sub list, my mean will be the previous mid plus 1. So my mean will be 11, because previously mid was 10. 10 plus 1 is nothing but 11. So my mean is also 11, max is also 11. Obviously my mid will also be 11, because 11 plus 11 is 22 divided by 2 is 11. So my mid is also at the position 11. Now let's check whether 43 is equal to mid of the array or not. Are they equal? No. Now let's check whether the key value is less than 52 or greater than 52. So 43 is less than 52. What does it indicate? That I need to move to the left sub list. While moving to the left sub list, I need to update my max. Now let's update it. My mean will be at the 11th position. So I'm very sorry, mean I am going to declare it as 12, but it should be at the position 11. That will be as it is, and my max will be, that should be at the 10th position. I'm very sorry, please let's consider this mean is at the position 11 and max is at position 10. Now here, if the mean and max are crossing their position, then it indicates that the search is unsuccessful and we need to stop at this position. I repeat, here mean should be at the position 11 and max should be at the position 10. They are crossing their positions, that's why it indicates that your search is unsuccessful and 43 is not present in my list. So in this way, the working of a binary search tree is there. For a binary search tree, this should be a binary search tree. I'm again really very sorry, this should be a binary search tree. The advantages of binary search tree is, practically it is widely used, because it is having the less time complexity. It is significantly faster searching comparison than that of the linear search. Binary search is very much faster than that of the linear search. So that's why practically it is used, and What are the disadvantages? So disadvantages are, this is not as simple as of the linear search because it can be implemented either with the help of either loops or recursively it can be implemented. And the binary search only works for a sorted list, whereas the linear search works for both, that is sorted as well as unsorted list. The time complexity for a binary search is big O log N. How to find out the time complexity for the binary search, that I am going to explain you separately. For this, you can go through the video of which I am going to flashing the shortcut link over here. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the contents and the video, please like the video and subscribe my channel Tech Talks. This is the logo or a symbol of my channel. Please do not forget to keep your bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos. Here I am providing a link to subscribe my channel. Please do subscribe my channel, and some of the links again I am providing here for your reference. Thank you.